procession for the first time, along with our colonial militia groups. The events we celebrate this weekend would not have happened without the Masons providing a private forum for the various segments of Boston society to convene and plot against the occupation. Dr. Joseph Warren and Paul Revere, two key leaders in the network of spies and messengers, were able to develop a close friendship with their assigned body. We welcome as co-sponsors of the lantern ceremony, the Red Sox Foundation and Massachusetts General Hospital Home Base Program, as we honor the veterans of Iraq and Afghanistan and their families. The Home Base Program is a great example of how our country should show its gratitude to the few among us who serve in harm's way. It is not enough to honor patriots from centuries ago without continuing to support those patriots who serve our country now. The treatment of our Revolutionary War veterans set the tone for an ambivalent response to veterans throughout American history. Paul Revere, though a civilian during his famous ride, joined the Massachusetts Militia and rose to the rank of colonel. He saw little action apart from supervising Castle Island, except for his participation in a rather unfortunate foray to Cascine, Maine. That foray bogged down as senior military officers, including Revere, dithered over military strategy long enough for British reinforcements to arrive. A civilian board back here in Boston unjustly placed the entire blame on Revere, who had to seek a military court-martial to clear his name. While Revere suffered an invisible wound to his pride and reputation, after the war he managed to prosper as a silversmith, shopkeeper, copper smelter, and military contractor. Many of his comrades in arms did not fare as well. The first congressional acts providing veterans benefits in the form of land grants were so circumscribed that few veterans benefited. The first federal pension act for Revolutionary veterans to provide assistance was not passed until 1818. The Old North Church is proud to honor both patriots past and the new generation of patriots today. As we wind down wars that have lost public support, let us not wind down our support for our soldiers and sailors who have sacrificed their time, their bodies, and their psyches to defend freedom around the world. Two historic Boston institutions, the Massachusetts General Hospital and the Red Sox Foundation, embody the continuing support we all need to show for our returning veterans and their families. The Home Base Program provides clinical and educational support to veterans and their families with invisible wounds from traumatic brain injuries and post-traumatic stress syndrome. As we honor both Paul Revere and today's veterans, I pray that each person here tonight find a tangible way to support those who have served us well and need our continuing support. The freedoms we enjoy are not free. It is our responsibility to continue to support those who have contributed so much for the liberty and freedom we cherish. Let us pray. Almighty God, we give you thanks for the courage of the men and women in our armed forces. We pray that we as civilians always support them in their work, whether or not we disagree with how they are deployed. We pray for their safety, for their safe return home, and we pray that we will do what we can to help them make healthy lives for themselves and their families. Amen.